Tonight's lineups are brought to you by Verizon Wireless. In John McClain's quest to get some scoring out of the Devils, he shuffles the lines once again. Here's what the Devils came out with in the pregame skate, what we expect to see for most of the night. Dynis Zubras up on a line with Ilya Kovalchuk and Alexander Vasyunov. Eliash and Arnott along with Matthias Tedenby, the impressive young Swede, and Travis Zajac, at least for the time being, expected to play on a line with Brian Rolston on his left and David Clarkson on his right. That fourth line remains intact. Pelly, Mayer, and Steven Gionta, whom you heard from in the pregame show. White and Talinder, Green, Valchenkov, Magnin, and Corrente are your defensive pairings for New Jersey. Of course, it's Marty Brodeur in goal and a big spot for the Devils against the Toronto Maple Leafs, a team currently mired in its own troubles, but coming off a very spirited win over Nash just a few nights ago. Let's see how it unfolds tonight. Upstairs we go to Doc and Chico.
John McClain, what do he and Jacques Lemaire have in common? Jacques Lemaire had this position behind the Devils bench before John McClain did. And then there is the Toronto coach, Ron Wilson. What do he and Jacques Lemaire have in common? The same number of wins, 588, tied for seventh overall as this game gets underway. And what do the two men behind these benches tonight have in common? Well, they realize there's pressure in every job, and coaching is one of them. MacArthur plays this across. Kuhlman brings it in and swings it back for Grabowski, poked away by Ralston, ahead now for Clarkson, and Clarkson is able to trickle it to the corner. MacArthur, the ex-Buffalo Sabre, swatted that one along and then was swatted himself by Clarkson, who now leans into Kuhlman, who bumped one ahead that Colin White took and twisted across for Parenti. Parenti able to lay this one right back out again, and it's grabbed off and just held deliberately by Francois Beauchemin, a member of the Anaheim Ducks Stanley Cup championship team just 3 years ago. Spirited in by Chris Versteeg, himself a champion from Chicago last year. This one battered around and then picked up by Versteeg, rags it and feeds it on back. A shot went just wide of Brodeur as there was traffic in front of him. It came from Komisarek. This one is rescued by Volchenkov. Eliash trickles it on, and it is lifted further, and Volchenkov moves after this one.
A little forechecking by Anton Volchenkov. A big shot of aggression there.
Eliash, the surrogate defenseman, played that one back across for the drop back in by Andy Green. I like the chaos of this already. Guys are changing positions here. The goalies may be next.
Well, Johnny McClain, maybe they got to get in on the offense. That might be the secret for the Devils. Marty Brodeur needs a couple assists. But Johnny McClain said they need some goals. And, of course, forward or a defenseman have to be a part of that process, Doc.
That one is pushed into Kovalchuk, banked around by Caberle, gotten by Kovalchuk, Caberle on him. It is flipped into some traffic and eventually grabbed off by Phil Kessel. Luke Shen gave it across to Tomas Caberle. 9 assists, no goals this year, as this is carried out by Kessel, and a shot went slipping wide and then is played back along further. Trouble came there as it's knocked away from Talinder. Worked back on, back to the point for the keep by Beauchemin. Taken on by Kessel. And Kessel rags but can't get by Kovalchuk, who steps on to center. Kovalchuk handed it over to Vasyunov, trying to go around behind Vasyunov. Nicely watched there by Beauchemin, and White with a shot that rattled off the glass, kicked off the back of the cage. Mike Komisarek flipped one on, and it rode the shelf for just a moment. And a nice play to keep play alive comes from Steven Gionta. Laid back across and carried on by the Leafs and dropped back in once again by Tim Prent. Young man who played at St. Michael's, not far away from this arena.
Dave Cameron was his coach, remember? Davey Cameron, the ex-New Jersey Devil. Well, it's time now. Lineups are brought to you by Verizon Wireless, and it's the Leaf lineup. And there you see a lot of names. You're saying, well, let's see, who's that guy? Oh, yeah, I remember Versteeg. He came from Chicago. But on the defense, Shen, the guy on the right, he's their big hope defensively, their first-round draft pick. And Caberle is a hope, Doc, I think, down the road that he's going to be someone they can trade at maybe the trading deadline, maybe before. He's going to be very desirable, I think, Caberle is, for a team that thinks they've got to run after the playoffs, or maybe just somebody who needs a good offensive defenseman. I know his name has been mentioned by Devils fans. Boy, we'd love to get him on our lineup for at least the rest of this year.
No less than 10 teams were reported interested in him over the summer, but interest is one thing and putting it up is another. A nice hit by Volchenkov that rocked MacArthur. Volchenkov, who makes sure that you know that he's around. Send that one to Green. They try to play further. Bounce back to Green. And Green dumps for Volchenkov. Carried back ahead by David Clarkson. And Clarkson fires one on goal that Gustafsson can play around for Shen to take. Gives on over to Caberle. And Caberle sent one ahead. It's always an interesting sound of the crowd here because they know hockey well. They do not respond to encouragement on a scoreboard. They just react. And there's a shot by Tedenby that ricocheted off someone in front. Started back out again by Nazem Kadri. Kadri trickled it back in. Colin White there, and Kadri wiped him out after he'd played it along. No luck there for the Leafs as it's played ahead to Eliash by Arnett and carried on by Tedenby. Tedenby, a shot turned aside by Gustafsson. Leafs turn to bring it back up with 4:10 gone in this opening period. Two shots to one, New Jersey. This one is lost, regained, lost again by Kadri and thrown back down where Kovalchuk lies after it. From the trapezoid, played along by Gustafsson to Gunnarsson. Lifted on a cross now for the take and the rag back by John Mitchell. Nice work by him. It's Mitchell watched by Andy Green, who took it right away. And Green can play it off the glass for Kovalchuk, who cannot get further with it because of Komisarek. Yanked around behind and watching this is Magnin as it is shoved back on. Vasyunov got it as far as center. Played in on a delayed offside. And now Chris Versteeg is able to rag it ahead and throw it back in. His name was misspelled on the Stanley Cup. Not his fault, of course. This is taken along now by Schustrom. Just get my name on there. Doesn't matter how it's spelled. It's on there forever. This is poked back along by Schustrom, but into some traffic. Banked right back to center, and Versteeg with a little swat on Magnin, who glares back.
And we should say, Duck, it's not an easy thing to correct once it's on the Stanley Cup, because all the letters are so tight and spoken for. It's not like you can just erase it.
No, that's the thing. There are X's on the Stanley Cup where there have been mistakes like we used to do on the typewriter years ago. Lob back in, and after this is Steven Ziontek. Carries off Colton Orr. The lockup there involves Rod Pelly. He and Colton Orr get tangled up. Meanwhile, Mayer gave it to Colin White, and a shot ricocheted off humanity at the circle and is just lobbed back out again by Tim Brent. Chip back ahead by Mayer. Knocked away from Shen. Good body position by Pelly. Coming by to jab it to him. Mayer. And the fling back out comes on across. Here's White with a drive. And that one held. Or blocked aside, I should say, from in front of Gunnarsson. And then cleared back down. And it will go for an icing. See, Colin White's letting that shot go pretty well back there, isn't he?
Devil's defense very involved. We noticed Volchenkov, his first shift, he chased down a puck. And then he kind of started a trend. David Clarkson coming home to play. He finishes one in
Volchenkov,
the offensive
sure
zone. Then at the blue line, Volchenkov with a couple of big ones trying to slow down that Clark MacArthur, who's on track, Doc, to have a career year. He's their hot scorer. So you want to try and take a little speed away from him by throwing some big checks.
The most goals he has ever scored was 17. And MacArthur checks in tonight with 7. And this is only game 18 of the year for him. Devils still probing as this is Talinder throwing it in. Clarkson stopped it there. Pulled away from Brent. Clarkson got it on to Zajac. On back. Talinder, a shot! And that deflected in front. Ryan Ralston was standing in front of Gustafsson.
Devils sure are using their D.
Here's Ralston again. Another shot is kicked aside by Brent. Battled for it in the half boards. Colton Orr able to throw it on back, and it's popped right back along by Keith Ollie. And out to where it must be played along by Corenti. Beg your pardon, sir.
No, I'm just saying I'd like to look at what the Devils are doing. They're getting a good deep forecheck going, and then they're trying to find that open defenseman at the point. So far, it's worked.
MacArthur has shot, and that one steered well wide by Corenti. Floated back on. Devils can move out. Eliash with it. Has Tedenby along with him. Arnett, just fresh from the bench, joins the play. Eliash holding and shooting one that's shrugged away. And then bounced for by Tedenby, and a quick shot is held by Gustafsson off the stick of the hot Patrick Elliott. No score, first period from T.O. overall as this game.
Tonight's quote book is brought to you by Geico. It comes from Marty Brodeur, and it's very interesting. He's talking about not being able to put together strings of strong games. He said, one game you feel like maybe you got it together. Next thing you know, you go 2-3 games backwards. Then you build yourself back up to try and play one good game, and you do it, but then you go back again another step. And boy, has that summed up this season, Doc. And this is a game, though, that Marty Brodeur and his mates know is almost a must victory. The points, the confidence, everything they can bring out of a game against Toronto can maybe jumpstart the team to put some of those games together.
A pass in front, ricochet off Gustafson, and then can be played further along by Kuhlman. Able to step by one, dumped ahead. Nice block by Andy Green and the cover by Tedenby. Laid back ahead, but off Jason Arnott, and so Gunnarsson is back to play that one along. Getting it is Elias, trickled further, but then knife going back to Green. Put it off Elias, and it rattled around for Jason Arnott. Arnott and Elias have played wonderfully together lately, despite the shutouts that the Devils have faced. They have been point producers in the games where the Devils have scored. Grabowski denied by the waffle board held by Marty Brodeur. Skate. This is carried right back ahead and lobbed in by Volchenkov. No icing on this play, so Francois Beauchemin takes over there. Former Columbus Blue Jacket gave it on to John Mitchell. Followed up now and knifed away from Versteeg. Shoulder there by Talinder. Yanked up the boards and the Devils take over yet again. Nice pitch back out by Zubras. Played further and then settled down for Zubras to bring on. Racking it by one. Dinah Zubras puts on the brakes trying to shake Mitchell. But Mitchell is able to prevail momentarily and scoop it over and handcuff Komisarek. But that's just hockey players' reflexes. He made something out of it to Versteeg.
That's right. A no-look pass.
How did they do that? Flipped ahead now for Versteeg to carry on. Tried to pull the trigger on a shot, and he got a strong one on goal. And Marty Brodeur made that stop. Right back ahead with it come the Devils, and it's Kovalchuk dragging now to pick up reinforcements, and then he's able to move his way ahead. Kovalchuk with a shot, and that one went wide. Bounced on over to Phil Kessel, dumped along to Shen. Nearing the halfway point of the first period, only 7 shots in the game, 4 by New Jersey. Carried right back ahead by Kessel again. Kessel a shot, shrugged away as Brodeur got a piece of that one. And it's carried back along and sent back off the stick of Steven Gianta. Fielded by Shen, and Shen is able to recoil and try to shake the checking of Pelle, which he did. Pass is cut by Gianta. Nice little feed ahead for Pelle, who walks in. Pelle with a backhander that wafted wide. Cavertly back defending. Tipped by Zajac and outletted ahead now for the carry back on by Kadri. Kadri dropped it back, poked away, controlled by the Devils, but they can't get out with it. Dealt right back along again. Kadri with a close quarters toss. Bozak stumbles down to the ice, gets right back up to play, and is wiped there by Green. Bozak fed, Kessel shot! Oh, and Brodeur stopped it and was able to wheel around and hang on.
Oh, Marty Brodeur, a little teasing on Phil Kessel. He's starting to come alive. Phil Kessel really went in a scoring drought after he went back to Boston and was booed. Really had trouble picking up any points, but the last game, it started to come. But Marty Brodeur, when the puck is bouncing around in the crease, there's no panic, Doc. You see how slowly he turns, tries to find it. That way he won't inadvertently knock it into his own net. But when you stop Phil Kessel, even if it's not clean, you're still pretty happy about it.
Here's a shot by Ollie that was blocked away. Right back out now for Clarkson to nudge back in. Clarkson after that one. Pretty effective check off there by Ollie, who dropped back. Meanwhile, lifted along in some traffic and jabbed at there near Ralston from Zajac. Volchenkov across. That went through the legs of Corenti. Is able to recoil back to Clarkson. Sent right back along again for Travis Zajac. Zajac gave it on to Ralston, but his pass is cut. And steaming back ahead is MacArthur, breaking on in, and a drive stopped by Brodeur. And play is stopped.
And a penalty, unfortunately. That was a disastrous turn of events, a huge giveaway. And at the end of that, a hooking call, I think, on Volchenkov. That's Clark MacArthur. Watch what he does. He snookers Ralston right there, who's going to get this puck. Bryant thinks that area is open, but MacArthur has snuck up. He takes the puck, roaring in. Volchenkov, there you see the hook, the blast, and the save by Marty. And Volchenkov on that play, I think, Doc, players, I know it's hard. It's so tempting to want to try and help the goalie, but you see, he gets the shot away anyway, but he gets called for what's a pretty insignificant hook, but something that the referees have to call.
Power play is on. This changed the game for the Leafs against Nashville. They got 4 power play goals in 8 opportunities, and they had 3 5-on-3s in the game.
Yeah, and they gave up a shorthanded goal. Talk about a power play that was hard to figure out. It's interesting. Both these teams, Doc, are coming off games where a 5-on-3 turned it. For the Devils, of course, the 5-on-3 against Boston, they got scored on. They never did recover. And here in Toronto, you see that scored on 4 of the 6 power play chances in the second period. They were down 4-1 and won it, hanging on at the end. But it was all power play. Devils would love to see some of that go their way.
Clark MacArthur, number 16, will be on the second wave of this power play. He's the one that drew the penalty in the first place to Volchenkov. As racing ahead now is Kessel. Here's Kessel. Hit the post with the shot. Taken on by Caverly now. Dropped it on back to Versteeg to Kessel again. Blocked there by Gionta and cleared.
Wow. Wow. Phil Kessel coming to life. He had first goal against Vancouver 2 games ago. And he hadn't had a point in 8 games before that. But like a lot of scores, Doc, Phil's a little streaky. And right now he's streaking and shooting pucks and hitting posts and scoring some points.
What a sequence. This is the Leafs holding on after the play was onside with all that acrobatics. Here is Kessel holding it now, dealing it back in. Kuhlman able to take over there. Kuhlman led it back. Caverly gave it across. Held there. Versteeg shot deflected wide as in front of the cage working there was Tyler Bozak. Bozak saw that one skip off his stick. Andy Green goes to play this. Wanted to reverse it back. Too many Leafs there. It's taken over by Toronto. And Bozak shook one back that is taken on now and thrown across the net mouth just wide of Kessel by Kadri. Twisted in front by Bozak and Brodeur blocked that one aside. And so it's Zajac taking in the last 22 of an eventful power play that has not scored for Toronto. A shift change. And finally, the second wave gets out with only 13 seconds left on a bleeding clock.
That's what's deceiving about a power play. They hit a post and had a puck go through the crease that very closely came to being a goal, Doc. So they had some good looks, the Leafs have.
Reminder of the 83-84 Devils who almost made it close a lot of nights.
There you go.
This is fun and ahead. Chico's words, not mine, and they're very entertaining, at least to me. Thrown back in now by Ralston. Penalty time is up.
Every game we lost, we had them for one moment, even if it was just before the drop of the first puck, as you see Adam Merrick get hit with a high stick, but no penalty.
Marty Brodeur watching. It's not in the trapezoid till now, but it's taken by Correnti, who was rubbed out by Kuhlman. Played back along from Correnti. Outletted as far as center, and it's forced on back by John Mitchell. Mitchell, sixth year in the organization, played for the Plymouth Whalers in suburban Detroit in the OHL. Here is Brodeur steaming one just away from Versteeg. Well, they're wearing contrasting colored uniforms, and he didn't hit the guy. He pushed it right past him, so no problem. Gunnarsson able to move it ahead. Versteeg up with it there. Challenged by Zubras, led back across. And that one cut off and steered on by Kovalchuk, but grabbed by Mitchell. Down to the ice he goes. Play continues with Zubras turning. Zubras could not run it in front. Taken to the outside. Kovalchuk a shot, and that held by Gustafsson. And play is stopped.
Well, let's go back, way back to that power play. We haven't had a stop and play since. And look at the speed here of Phil Kessel. He steps wide, leans, and rips it off the post. No rebound there. Devils did a good job of covering. And look at that spin by Zubras. He takes 3 leaps with him. And Kovalchuk's then allowed to grab it off the left wing. Right-handed shot. Tries to go high glove. But Gustafsson with a good save. But Phil Kessel, Doc, you want to stay close to him tonight. He looks like he's got the wheels and the hands in gear.
5 scoring chances for Toronto. And Kessel has 4. Chris Versteeg with the other 1. The Devils have 3. Eliosh and Tedenby with 1 each. Included in the 3 as this is sent back in and Marty Brodeur stops it there. Forced it back ahead. Tedenby gets it. Outlets on now to Eliosh, moving up with Arnott. But stolen and wafted right back in again. Good job done by Tim Brent, former Anaheim Duck farmhand that Brian Burke probably spotted there. This directed across. Caverly tried to force it further and must retreat now. Caverly's been a part of this for 12 years. Carried back on. Luke Shen, part of this team for 3 years now. Sees this one cut by Zajac, led back ahead. David Clarkson, open alley up the wing. Clarkson dips the shoulder and a rising backhander went wide. On it comes now to Tillinder. Tillinder shoots one that's off the glove of Shen. Zajac sent it on to Clarkson, who protects. Away from Bozak, Clarkson turning, dropping it back near Zajac, swatted by Shen, and the puck escapes to the opposite side. Forage after that, and Clarkson with a falling backhand that was on goal and had to be stopped by Gustafson.
Two good chances for David Clarkson on this particular shift. Of course, his family's here as well as Clarkie's kids, his charity from Kitchener, so he's got a lot of active support here tonight.
And he's the leading shoot-on-goal guy on this team, entering tonight with 54 shots on goal. A conscious effort by him to shoot more. Paid off for Sidney Crosby. Drive is saved by Marty Brodeur. The rebound is curled away by Kuhlman. Handed on back for the play by Beauchemin. Led to no one in particular, and so it careens on back where Mike Komisarek will go to get it. West Islip guy played it back on to Beauchemin. Taken back on now by Grabowski. Kyle Grabowski's pass escaped. And so both teams make a change in lines with a little over 4 minutes to go. The shot's even at six. Trouble there for Volchenko.
Well, he's going, hey, I made a good pass, but there's lines that's got to get out of the way.
It's worse when the trouble comes from the stripes, isn't it?
It is.
Three on two developing, hustling to get back Gianta. Schustrom a shot and a challenge there and a save by Brodeur. Coming by to take it from Schustrom, Rod Pelly tumbles down to the ice, continues to play from his knees, but a shot flopped into the glove of Brodeur, a half-speeder from John Mitchell. 3:34 to go, first period of play. We have no score.
Watch that left foot of Christopher Stieg. That's why Marty Brodeur's upset. He's got it clearly in his glove. And he gets swiped and kicked at. Versteeg's not a dirty player, but Marty's thinking two things. In Boston, there's a loose puck in the crease, and Adam Mayer pokes at it. He gets a penalty to put us down to. Here, I've got the puck clearly in my glove. They kick at it, which is a dangerous motion, and no penalty. So he let the referee have it for quite a while during that intermission break.
Here's Kessel feeding one off the stick of Brodeur, which is omnipresent tonight in blocking those passes from behind the line that the Leafs are trying. Ollie played it ahead. Stan Laurel had nothing to do with it. Green able to lob one on that is taken right back up by Patrick Elias, shakes away from one, and then fires it back in.
Well, the old guys would be laughing at that joke.
That's what Stan would like.
Yes, that's
about
right.
It. This one ricocheted off of Arnott and went into the first row. They can't play it there. Devils fans, stay tuned for the first period intermission report presented by Dunkin' Donuts color analyst Sherry Ross. Ooh. We'll be here to chat with Steve.
Well, actually, the Devils are hoping that the Leaf game turns into a Laurel and Hardy epic. But right now, both teams not playing very well. I think the passing has been pretty sharp. Players have been very conscientious, and I think both teams really want to get through the first period without any disastrous event happening. And so far, that's what's been going on.
Andy Green played that one back in. Tedenby trying to fight it further. It is delayed on and then played back up, but hooked by Kuhlman in a fortunate bounce for the Leafs. Carried right back ahead, and here's Kessel with it, and his shot was blocked off. Good job done there by Volchenkov, who will probably always be out there when Kessel is, and the same with Green. Volchenkov and Green have come to the bench now. Meanwhile, this is carried back on by Caberle. Caberle sidestepped the hip check attempt of David Clarkson, but that was enough to throw the play offside.
Well, Johnny McClain, always optimistic, even though his team, only team not to win two straight games, but again, you know, what can you do? They're working hard in practice. Yesterday, they worked on a lot of specialty teams. He gets them well prepared, and I know I'm listening and I'm watching and I'm reading, Doc. A lot of people want to focus the blame on Johnny McClain. I understand fans. I am not telling them what to do. But just don't think that's the simple solution to the Devils' problems, because it is not.
Well, when you look at those stats about goals scored and you see them number 30 in the league, there's only so much that the all-time leading goal scorer for the Devils can do about that.
Yep.
But
yep.
At any rate, here is Gunnarsson controlling for the Leafs in the last 2:10 of the first period. Played back in at Brian Ralston, and so Gunnarsson will try yet again. The other way, oh, and Ollie was smashed to the boards and glass by Ralston. The puck sails out of play near the Leaf bench.
Well, both these coaches in the news a lot because their teams are struggling, and will they make it to live again and win another hockey game? Well, Ronnie Wilson won a big one the other night, 588
career victory for him. It ties him with Jacques Lemaire, which is pretty heady company. And I like Ronnie Wilson. He's straightforward. He doesn't take any guff. He lives on the edge, Doc. And I think he's going to, if he can last long enough, and I think he will, the Leafs have a making of a pretty decent future with a lot of their young players.
Very much like other teams that have come along and posted championships after they had weak years because of the draft situation. And Toronto has not had much in the way of playoff opportunity lately, and that usually leads to a better draft position as long as you keep them. Kovalchuk hands on now to Vasyunov. Vasyunov forced it on back, chopped back out again by Komisarek, and it must be retrieved. Kovalchuk swept it across, and Karenti got it there. Off the stick of Zubras and wide to be planed down there and held for Komisarek, I should say, by Gustafson, and eventually grabbed off here by Tillinder and sailed back in. Up the boards it comes for the play back on by Colin White.
Rod Talley getting a chance to play wing with Arnaud Elias.
Ahead now comes Kessel trying to get by Tillinder. Nice denial by Tillinder. Henrik Tillinder slipped it along to Arnott, and that one comes back to the safety of center. Strength against strength that time, and Tillinder prevailed. Haverly fed it ahead. Laid back on again by Kadri. Lifted on by Arnott and eventually grabbed by Patrick Elias, who shakes it right back in again. Shen able to turn away from the forecheck of Arnott. Luke Shen guided it across. Rushed right back again and handed across now. Kadri a shot, getting a piece of it, Brodeur, as it hopped to the corner. Kadri tries to play it further, but it's popped back out again by Brian Ralston in the last 20 of the opening frame.
Well, speaking of draft picks, the Leafs' first-round draft pick from last year, Kadri, almost got his first. As again, the Devils are going to be whistled down for a penalty that's really going to turn into the beginning of the second period. But here's this young Kadri coming off the wing here. He's going to get the pass. Fake toe drag off. I think it was off Volchinkov and then off the shoulder of Marty Brodeur. But there you see the skate trip by Brian Ralston. I don't know if it's accidental or not. Doesn't matter. Good call by the official. See, I can be supportive of those guys in stripes.
I think this is really a testament to how great you've been. Here, it's on back now to Versteeg. Versteeg with a shot knocked down in front. Rebound! It chipped in front. Oh, a close call there. Devils hoping for the horn, and they get it now.
And Marty Brodeur, some big saves. Leafs hit a post. They had a couple other scoring chances, but all that matters is the Devils are still even with no score in this hockey game.
And an epiphany moment with 10 seconds left in the period by Mr. Resch concerning officials. Devils fans looking for a way to catch only the games that fit your schedule this season? Design your own personal Devils ticket plan with our Flex Ticket Package. Pick your games, pick your seats. It's that simple. Call a Devils ticket representative today at 1-800-NJ-DEVIL or visit NewJerseyDevils.com to get started. Don't miss any of the exciting action at the Rock this season. Join the Devils Army today. These two played together a decade ago and were magic with Peter Sikora. And look what they've done lately in the last five games now. The Devils have been shut out a couple of times. But look at this. Six assists, 15 shots, and a plus two. Jason Arnott has been even during that time with 19 shots, 3-1. So 10 points, 34 shots over the five games for Arnott and Elias. Christine Simpson with Ilya Kovalchuk.
Thanks very much, Doc. Ilya, both of these teams came into this game wanting to prove they're better than their records indicate so far. Your sense on the first period, how do you think you guys did?
I think we did pretty good. You know, we didn't give them a lot of chances. They hit the post once. We just have to stay away from the penalty box because those on the PK, we had that skillness. You know, we have to play 5-on-5 or power play. We have to move our feet in their zone and create some.
John McClain was asked before this game if he puts more pressure on you to perform, and he said no. It's 20 guys on this team. But I got to ask, do you put more pressure on yourself? Do you feel like you should be contributing more?
Yeah, but I like that kind of pressure, you know, and that's why I'm signed here, because the expectations are very high, and you know, everybody waiting for me scoring and create chances. So that's what I'm trying to do, and I just have to keep working.
Well, as you said, the penalty kill is how you'll start the second period. How do you soldier through that?
Yeah, you know, we got lately our guys did a great job, so we just need to kill and go from there.
Thanks, Ilya.
Okay, thank you.
Ilya Kovalchuk, the New Jersey Devils. No score here after 20 minutes of play at the Air Canada Center. After these messages, we'll be back with the Dunkin' Donuts first intermission report. Stay tuned.
Seconds away is Charles the Quacker. New Jersey Devils hockey on MSG Plus is brought to you in part by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit us at geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO. By Acura, Acura Advance. And by Verizon Wireless, the signal is yours. Wield it to transmit anything you want. Verizon. Largest city in Canada, Toronto. And Chuck the Duck was here today. There you see him going by the baseball dome stadium, right?
Yes, yep, yep. And the CNN tower there on the right, Rogers Stadium on the left. He's been cruising on. In Boston, he was speeding along 50, 60 miles an hour. Look, he doesn't lose his cool, doesn't lose his cigar. He's got great beak. You know, some players have great hands. The Duck's got the great beak, Doc. And here he is in a little four.
Where is he, in the subway? What is this?
Oh, he's coming in for the game.
He's down near our production truck.
Uh-huh. And he's probably somewhere in the building. Maybe that'll be a next contest. You know, where's Waldo?
Yeah.
Where's the Duck? I don't know, but
he did put the cigar out when he came in, we are told, because he was inside the arena. And it's unlike in the old days when you used to have to play in smoky arenas, Chico, in the IHL and the American League in New Haven. Oh. Smoking is not allowed here in Toronto.
Kessel. How about smoking dressing rooms?
Oh, yes.
When I broke in, Mike Bossy was still smoking in the dressing room.
Power play underway here for the Leafs at the start of the period. Here's Bozak just holding up and filtering it through, hoping for help from Kessel. Rattles around, and Kessel is able to come up with it. Phil Kessel scaled it back around, waiting for this as Caberle drilled it back behind, but it's Talinder up with that one. Shakes it off the glass, could not be stopped, goes all the way back down, and striding after it is Gionta. It's not at the trapezoid yet, and then was hooked away by Gustafson. Phil Kessel was a force in that period, but he had only one shot on goal. He had one off the post, and he had an impressive shot that missed, but only one shot on net. Meanwhile, ahead with this now, and burrowing on is Grabowski in a shot. Nice pad stop made by Brodeur, and he just reached out, flexed it away so the Devils can clear.
And that tells me Marty Brodeur is right. Elbow is 100%. That was a nice save and poke check. You know, you're talking about shots. Doc, I mentioned the Devils' defense were kind of involved in the play, yet I look at the scoring sheet, and they didn't have a shot on goal. That's got to change, because they only got six total.
Devils need a power play of their own here. They've not had one yet. Volchenkov and Ralston are the two who have taken the infractions. And the Ralstonian minor has only 14 seconds left to go in. Long pass ahead. Oh, what a great stop by Brodeur. And now it's score! Grabowski, power play goal, 1-0.
But as you know, the folks that just saw it at home, this doesn't look like a power play. These aren't the kind of power plays you want to give up. It's a two here, but a pretty nice move. Kuhlman inside, outside. Brodeur has to stop it with his pad, but all alone down the slot. Grabowski just hammers that. Oh, there you see the sliding Rod Pelly just missing, blocking it. But you know, Doc, you kill off a penalty, you're almost due. There's no setup. You think, okay, we could maybe kind of regroup here instead off a rush. The Devils get beat on a big rebound.
Grabowski's fifth, his second power play goal of the year. Kuhlman, the primary assist with the initial shot. Commissary gives it across. Beauchemin threw it back down, and so it is Colin White turning there in an icing.
And that's his fifth goal in the last six games. We talk about streaky scores. There's lots of them, and it's hard to score consistently, but when you're on a roll, the puck just seems to like you there. Grabowski just hammered it, and Marty was screened, and then the puck just reappeared through the two Devils. I think it was White and Pelly, and it was behind Brodeur before he could move. But now the Devils have to start creating some offense. It's just a must.
MacArthur got the secondary assist. That's his sixth assist in the last three and a fraction games. He has been hot. Here is a shot that ricocheted to the corner.
shot attempted there by Talinder. Meanwhile, it hopped on over the glass. Devils won a penalty call there, and the linesmen and referees, I think, are going to have a conference. And maybe they're drifting apart now. Maybe we're going to get a penalty call against Toronto, sure enough.
We're just waiting to see who it is. And Johnny Mitchell, I think, sitting down as that puck was in the air, and he batted it and sent it over the glass. So the Devils get that power play chance that you were talking about, Doc. And this power play for the Devils have to start to produce. It's their biggest hope to start scoring goals and getting wins.
Three of the last eight over a three-game span after being one for the prior 33. This one is flexed loose by Elias, grabbed off by Clarkson, trying to get a shot away. But Versteeg stood in the way of that. There was no hand pass coming from that, waved off by the referee. Meanwhile, the Leafs have time and space to decide what to do, and clearing it is number one. Marty Brodeur tends this one. The shots are 12-6 in favor of the Maple Leafs here. Devils looking for their first shot of the period, nearly 3 minutes played. Gunnarsson around behind, able to lob one that is taken there by Patrick Elias, handed on back, and it's Green with it. Green hands back over to Elias again. Over for Jason Arnott. Arnott, the leading goal scorer on the team with six, curled that one around, and it is jabbed loose and back to center ice by Mike Brown.
Devils struggling just to get their power play set up. Let's see how they do off the rush.
Zajac feeds ahead, carried on by Kovalchuk. Finessed in front, little pass across from Zajac for Zubras, wrestled down by him, handed on back. Ralston gave it over to Green, dropped back across to Kovalchuk again. Finessed it back to Green. One-time shot is blocked right back out by Mike Brown. Green readies again, and Brown had dropped down. Now it's Green shoveling it across, drive by Kovalchuk, and that one blocked wide. Turn back along again to Ilya Kovalchuk. Walks with it, hands it across. Shot, bad stop made by Gustafson on the try by Rawlson.
Well, there's a difference in the hockey game. Devils with a big rebound off the goalie pads, but it eluded all the Devils driving the net.
Versteeg to the outside, trying to rag his way through, and it's turned over now to Kovalchuk. 15 seconds to go, power play. Pass misfires, and around to play at Beauchemin. Backhands it further, and it careened all the way out to center where Talinder will have to even go back into his own end. So that takes care of the power play time. Penalty time is up. Mitchell out of the box. Full strength action. Early second, 1-0 in favor of Toronto. And John Mitchell going for a skate with it here. Oakville, Ontario native, lost it. Kovalchuk across, and a shot into the glove of Gustafson.
Well, Gustafson didn't see much action when the Devils had the man advantage, but after the turnover by Mitchell, Ilya Kovalchuk grabs that biscuit and trying to use the D as a the Leaf defenseman as a screen, goes high on that glove. Oh, and that's a terrific save by Gustafson as he gets down low. And because Kovi shoots a lot for the glove side coming off that wall, Doc, that goalies are kind of set up with their weight ready to go to the glove, and that's exactly where the puck went.
This is Talinder with this one. Talinder fed, Pelle with the shot, cut off and started out by the Leafs, and here's Kessel moving up the wing. The challenge there, and he's able to shake Krejci out, the save, Brodeur! Rebound came in front, and Brodeur hangs on to that one.
Oh my, Phil Kessel just on the edge of exploding and putting the Devils in a heap of trouble. Now, Steven Gionta got caught backing up as defenseman, so this isn't necessarily a great match here. There you see Gionta playing defense. He starts fishing for that puck, just what Kessel was hoping for. And the quick toe drag, he walks in, Brodeur with the save. Marty's got to scramble and find that rebound. But the Devils are going to have to reverse things here, Doc. Way too many quality scoring chances against and not enough in their favor.
Hasn't happened yet, though, has it?
No, and
balance of power has not shifted to them yet.
Here we go, 2-on-1.
Zubras brings it on. Zubras fed one across that is spiked away by Beauchemin, who got back on the play. Kovalchuk takes over here. Hurried shot by Volchenkov. Pinballed off a couple of Leafs, taken then by Zubras. Dina Zubras holds and fed one off Kovalchuk, popped up high, and must be settled down by Volchenkov at center to Magnin and dropped on back. 5:20 gone, second period. Shots are 13-8 in favor of the Leafs. Ahead comes Versteeg with a shot that's shrugged away by Brodeur. Bouncing puck is settled down by Zajac and scooped across. Rifled up the wing. Kovalchuk able to take it there. Puts on the brakes and looks. And threw one in front that was cut off and sent back out again by Kaberle.
Leafs not making it easy for the Devils because their back check has been outstanding. It's coming. The back check is with speed and great hockey sense, Reed. And they're picking up the loose Devil coming late. So maybe the Devils have to think of pulling up Doc, shooting the puck on net, and then looking for a rebound rather than a nice pass through the slot.
Well, Devils fans over the last decade, or maybe even decade and a half, will attest to the fact that back checking can be taught.
Yeah, and very effective, can win championships.
Zajac laid this one back, angled on ahead up the wing. It hopped away from Ralston off his stick. Gustafson flings one along. Not as sure-handed with his goal stick as some, but they got the bounce they wanted. Grabowski pitched it to center. Turning with it is Correnti, and Correnti slides it back across for Andy Green. Green's pass ricocheted off Eliash and back in. Angled back out once more, and it's Correnti with it. Andy Green tried to filter it through, went off of Arnott. Started back ahead and flicked in by Tim Brent, and he goes right after it with Correnti. Swatted around by Arnott, taken on there and slung right back, but Colton Orr is able to block that one. Orr stymied there for a moment, and then it sped back out, the turn and the take, and here comes Arnott with it. Arnott a shot, and a toe save is made there, getting his pad on it was Gustafson. Play is stopped, the net is dislodged. With 12:59 to go, second period of play. Grabowski from Kuhlman and MacArthur, the only scoring play, 1-0 Leafs.
I want to show you the importance of the direction of a rebound. You know, here's a Leafs goal. You tell me how different this is. Off Marty Broder's pad, pass Colin White, Grabowski hammers it home. Now the Devils come down, do some good work. Jason Arnott gets loose, makes a nice smart shot to the right side, but in that case, Tenenby gets blocked out. Rebound was there. If you could have got to it, be 1-1. Doc, I'm not trying to make excuses for the Devils, but you can't say they're not trying. You can't say they're just not working smart. That was a terrific shot by Arnott to give an opportunity for a rebound. Tenenby drove the net, but good defensive play by the Leafs. So the Devils just have to hang in and continue to do that and hope that that unseen hand, the puck luck god, starts to work in their favor.
Here's the hold by Bozek and the set for Beauchemin. Oh, and Brodeur was bumped, perhaps by his own defenseman, Magnin. And that's the reason no penalty call. Thrown side of the net. Score! Kessel!
Well, you, me, and the 20,000 fans here could predict this. We kept saying, this guy's on a roll tonight. But what really makes this difficult for Brodeur is that Kessel has all kinds of time, and he's a right shot off the left wing. So he's got that puck to the far side of the net. And what happens here? Jason Arnott slides up. He loses track of where Kessel is. And you see Volchenkov step up. And Magnin doesn't see him till the very end. And Phil just steps out, Doc. And I don't know if he put it off the post, but he is shooting the lights out. When he gets the opportunity, the post has stopped him once. Brodeur's pad stopped him another time, but that time it was nothing but net.
In this month of November, which there's a lot of talk about cancer survivorship, Phil Kessel is one of those, and he is on straight 30 goal years, and he now has 9 this season in his first 18 games. Cadre gets one assist and Komisarek the other.
Well, the Devils just totally broke down there, Doc, and we'll maybe look at it again to see what happened, because I mean, Kessel's the one guy you want to know where he's on and where he's at on the ice, but they completely lost him and got burnt for it.
Boy, quick shot off the faceoff by Pelly that was answered by that lightning-like pad strapped to Gustafson. Kept by Colin White. Around behind, Mayer couldn't stop it. It is Clark MacArthur floating on. Grabowski right there. Well, you can't tell me that the Leafs are a team that only has won one of the last 10 games, but that's it. I mean, they're really playing with fluidity when it means coming out of your own zone. Perfect pass, guy in stride, everything working just fine for them. Dealt back in again by Kuhlman, and around to get this is Andy Green. Roughed up a bit by MacArthur. Kept going, though. Nice puck control to give to Clarkson. and worked on ahead for Zajac to feed Ralston for the shot that is held by Gustafson.
Well, let's take a look at that last Leaf goal. Let's see what happens now. You're going to just, can we just stop it here, guys? And as you look here, Devils in good shape. Three guys covering the front of the net. But over here is Kessel. And look at how the Devils all shift. They're all shifting over to the right. And Kessel just stays where he is. Can't believe it. And the Leaf with the puck. The primary assist from Kadri, the young rookie. His second assist of his career. But he finds him. And then Kessel just has the time and space. And that, if you ask Phil Kessel, what did you like the best? What was the best part of that goal? He'd say, the time I had to make the decision, the time I had to set up and execute it. Because in the National Hockey League, things happen at lightning quick speed. But for him, it seemed like he could have had a Dunkin' Donuts coffee and a roll.
Around to the outside, Ralston swept one that ricocheted off Gustafson and wide. Brought back up by Kessel. Moves on in. Here's Kessel delaying to Shin. Canceled out by Zajac and by Clarkson. And this one squibbed to Andy Green.
There again, tough break. David Clarkson thought he was down to block the shot. If he'd stayed on his feet, he would have had a 2-on-1. He thought the Leaf was going to execute the shot. He didn't. And the play broke down.
Kadri moving on in. On a shot by Kessel. Another try. And Brodeur blocked it and is able to cover and play a stop.
Oh boy, I don't know if Johnny McLean takes a timeout or the Devils just give their head a shake. But what they've got to do is, boys, somebody has got to know where that Phil Kessel is every shift he's on. Now, does Brodeur get this? Puck bounces loose.
Oh, sorry.
Nope. No, that's okay, Doc. You were screened like I was. I couldn't tell if it was going wide, hit Andy, but it actually hit Andy Green's foot. But the Leafs come close. Again, the Devils need to keep this from 3-0. I know it's obvious.
Just as it was in Boston, the third goal has been such a problem to the Devils, so rarely do they ever get that many.
Yes.
So it's shoved on back to Mike Komisarek. Komisarek threw it wide off the back of the cage. The first to every puck tonight seems to be wearing white and blue.
You're right, especially since about the 5-minute mark of that first period. You remember this, the Leafs have scored 7 straight goals going back to last game.
Komisarek, or check that, it is Kovalchuk throwing one in front off of Komisarek, taken on then again by Kovalchuk, and he readies it, plays it back in for Bastyunov. Score! At the front of the net, it was Zubras, and Dinah Zubras has deflected it home and cut the lead in half.
Well, this is a great goal by the Devils for a number of reasons. Because they get the puck deep, but it looks like it's going to break down and nothing's going to happen. But watch the pursuit here. There the puck goes out into the slot area, but the Devils stay with it. Good job by Tolinder to get it back deep. And Kovalchuk took the right path to be an easy option to get that return pass. And then Vasyunov looking to bank it off something. The goalie, the Leaf defender, or better yet, is centerman, Dinas Zubras. Dinas takes a swing at it, Doc. I don't know if he struck the puck with his stick or it hit the toe of his skates and went in the net. Either way, it would be legal. I think they're delaying just a little to make sure. But there was nothing illegal, even though it may have gone off the skate of Zubras. But that's a huge goal for New Jersey. As I said, the Leafs have scored 7 straight goals without giving up one. And now at least the Devils, I think, have put a little bit of doubt into the Leafs that maybe things aren't going to be as easy as they've been for the first half of this hockey game, and they're still waiting to have another look at it. And we saw it, Doc, and there was no kicking motion. But and sometimes I think you do look, but by now it should be clear. Look at Dinas Zubras is going here. He's swinging at it. He actually gets it with his stick. So what's the delay? Here you'll see number 8 down low. Swings at it, and it might have even went off his toe, but it's clear there's nothing to review here. So the Devils are saying, come on, let's go. We scored a goal. We want to get fired up here. And the thumbs up says, drop the puck.
They heard you.
we want to get going too, right, Doc?
That's right. Zubras from Bastyunov and Kovalchuk. The temperature inside the arena tonight is, I think, 8 Celsius. And so we're both working on coffee. Perhaps you can tell we're a little jumpy. I don't know. Anyway, fed back at the half boards and picked up now and held along further by Tedenby. Tedenby just rags the puck, flips to the back, got it there for Magnin, sent around behind, and Arnott is after it. Arnott chipped it on. Eliash got it there. Patrick Eliash defended away by Brent. Meanwhile, it is sped back on by Shannon, outletted by Orr, on across for the carry by Mike Brown. Brown with a backhander, shrugged away by Marty Brodeur. Brown after it again. U.S. National Team Development Program in Ann Arbor, and then he went on to school there for a couple of years at Michigan. Bounced on out to center where it is tipped across and eventually regathered by Grabowski. Tried to swing it ahead. It went off Eliash and is grabbed by Vasyunov. Vasyunov tries to pull his way on. A little help from Kovalchuk, but he can't come up with it. And then it is filtered ahead, and here is Grabowski moving and shooting. Oh, a strong shot. May have glanced off Brodeur and hopped wide, but at any rate, Grabowski is right there again. Comes out in front. What'll he do? Decides to rag it along the boards and pick up reinforcements. Fresh defenseman out for the Leafs. One of them, Beauchemin, let one go. Blocked away, paddled on by Brodeur. Outletted ahead for the Devils to scoop it on across. And the carry on now by Zubras. Zubras controls to the slot. Turnaround backhander, ricocheted right back out. And is taken by Vasyunov. Chopped it behind to Zubras. Pulling his way at the front is Kovalchuk. Pass went where he had been and can be taken on now by Kuhlman. Eli Kuhlman could not get by a good defensive play made by Andy Green. So Brodeur sets as we're down to the last 7 minutes and change here in the second period.
Ronnie Wilson, the coach of the Leafs, he's elected to go as his, perhaps his top line, MacArthur, Grabowski, and Kuhlman against the Kovalchuk line. Doc, so that's an interesting matchup. There's a lot of firepower, but also maybe an opportunity for either line to break down. And but this is really the dangerous line for the Leafs, right? Kessel has been a one-man wrecking show.
Kozak dropped it. Kessel, the shot pad stopped. Brodeur spiked to the glass by Green. Pinballed out for Mayer, and Mayer looks ahead. Nudges a pass on that's given across by Corenti, but a misfire there, and so it's thrown back up by Shen. Grabbed by Corenti again. And dropped on out. Adam Mayer charges on. Gave it on the wing to Pelly. Pelly with a shot. Spirited away by the goal stick of Gustafsson. And right back up with it again comes Bozek trying to play it through. No luck there. Diving play will be offside. And so the clock stopped with 6:57 to go second period. Virtually nonstop time to sell something here. I mean, help us. 2-1 Toronto.
Maple Leafs with the 2-1 lead here in the second as we welcome you back to the Air Canada the center. Well, Toronto native Clarkson always loves coming home, and tonight he's got a very special group cheering him on. Clarkie's Kids, a charity he began back in his junior days with the Kitchener Rangers. And tonight, five children from the Grand River Hospital in Kitchener are here with their parents. It's something he's done throughout his career. They'll be looking forward to meeting David and the team after the game. And coming up in the second intermission, you'll hear more from Clarkson on just why this cause is so special to his heart. Doc?
We'll look forward to that. It is played on by Talinder Gianta. Smeared out of the play, and it careened on back now for Mitchell, but his pass misfired. One of the better human beings in the sport that sort of has a tie of about 500 guys for whatever position you consider the highest ever. But ahead now, this is off the back of Gianta's skate, and it causes an offside, so play is stopped. It was 40 years ago today that Punch Imlach returned to Toronto with a team called the Buffalo Sabres. He was given two standing ovations at Maple Leaf Gardens, and his Sabres walked in and beat the Leafs 7-2. And there was another ovation at the end of the game. They don't forget people that they once liked.
Well, not if you were a member of the Stanley Cup team.
That's right.
But those people are becoming far and few between, unfortunately, Doc. You know, how many years ago was it been, would you say today, 42 since they won the Cup?
42 seasons, yeah. Because there was a lockout. Boy, that's a pretty strong stop by Gustafsson there on the shot by Vasyunov. Fildered ahead, charging on his Kuhlman. One hands one that Brodeur stops and covers. And this is not 2-1 because of Marty Brodeur tonight. That's for sure. My goodness, he's been strong.
You are right. And this is a difficult play for Brodeur, only because he doesn't know how much room Kuhlman's going to have. You're going to see Talinder. Wonderful job of not taking a penalty, but not allowing Kuhlman to get both hands on the stick and shoot that puck. It's more of a shovel. Oh, you know what? That was Talinder that guided that puck into Brodeur. But that's okay. I'd sooner have my own defenseman putting it where I can get it rather than the opposition. But again, near breakdown. The Devils are starting to show some weaknesses on those quick plays through the neutral zone, and they've got to tighten up in that.
They have 6 minutes and 3 seconds before they'll be told that as a group.
Yeah.
Line by line, they're probably being told right now by Larry Robinson and by John McClain at the bench area. Started ahead now for Bozak to bring on. Hands up for play to be made by Kadri on to Kessel, and a shot was snuffed out by Magnin. Turned right back ahead for the Devils to outlet. It's Patrick Eliash bringing it on. Charges right back in with Tedenby. Eliash to the outside, twisted a pass that came over to Kessel. Wasn't expecting it. Recovered, though, and put a pass ahead that can be handled now by Bozak. Tyler Bozak flipped it across. Taken there by Kadri. Kadri walking on. Dips the shoulder. Could not get by Magnin. But again, played by the Leafs with 5 1/4 to go in period number 2. Flipped along by Magnin. Moving back in is Kessel. Kessel dealt it further. Kadri cross-bodied there and held to the boards by Arnott. Meanwhile, taken around behind and spiked away further. Rocked a little bit was Kessel. Kessel able to emerge. Took a chop at his stick. Nice kick across by Tedenby, and he got it back again. And Matthias Tedenby, as the Devils are changing, throws one in that is trapped there, and then deciding the better of it was Gustafson. And I think the same way he did. Do I do it? Yeah. No. Yeah. 2-1 lead.
We've talked about the last Leaf team to win the Cup, and that was the center figure there. Johnny Bauer, look at that poke check as he beats Kenny Worm, as Kenny Worm tries to go across the crease. And here you got Béliveau and Tim Horton behind him. Johnny again, no mask, just fearless. He's 84 years old. He still attends some of these Leafs games. They just go crazy when they either meet Johnny or see him at a game, and there he is hanging from the rafters. And just, now you talk about David Clarkson being a wonderful human being.
Yeah. He
is, but this Johnny Bauer, Doc, is absolutely the nicest guy you are ever going to meet. And he's just so cordial and warm, and he's got funny stories of when he played, and very complimentary, and just a great guy. I've been able to spend some time with him, and I just can't be around him enough.
Hunch Imlach, who we talked about earlier, after that was seen sipping champagne, and printed on the blackboard behind him were the words, "No practice tomorrow." Stanley Cup was right there. Around comes Brown. Oh, and a sprawling play made by Brodeur. He is on all fours, gets back to his feet without his goal stick, and now has gotten it back. In position should a shot come his way. Meanwhile, Orr flips one. There's a stray stick out there, but it is a skater stick rather than the goalie stick. Brodeur is fine, at least that way. Dealt around behind, and he stepped into Versteeg as he went by. I think he owed him one from the first period, he felt, so why not make contact? Here's Versteeg again. Rocked a little bit by Zajac. Versteeg turns with it now. Moves out in front, and a shot bounced off of Schuster, who's able to carry it behind. He sent one across the net mouth. Versteeg has that one. And the coverage a little leaky right now. Versteeg centers one. Came on back. Komisarek, a shot blocked and then covered by Marty Brodeur, who at times has been all that there has been.
Well, he's certainly been the guy between the score starting to move up into threes and fours and it remaining at two. And here you're going to see Mitchell cutting across the net. Green can't get him, but Matt Carinthy helps out, and Brodeur goes down and reads that perfectly and steps out and is able to poke that away. Excuse me, it was Mike Brown. And then after that, Marty with the save off, then off the shin pad of Green. And it comes back to Brodeur, and he's able to cover it. So Brodeur and just gave one of the Leafs a punch there. I like that fire.
Nice stop yet again by Marty Brodeur. 20th shot on goal tonight by the Maple Leafs, 216 for New Jersey. Komisarek to handle this. Banged it around off Kuhlman. The battle at the half boards. Kovalchuk got it, but his pass came on the money for MacArthur with 3:10 to go in the period. Lobs one ahead. Grabowski able to shake loose from the shove by White. Stick handles on his knees. Gets back up, plays it further, and controls. Grabowski just holding now. Pop one that is gathered in by Kovalchuk with a head of steam. Sized up there by Beauchemin. Pass across to Zubras. Able to tap one further, and it's controlled by Vasyunov. Vasyunov has it hyped away by Kovalchuk, but sped behind, where it's Beauchemin to play it back ahead for MacArthur. Moving back out with Kuhlman. Grabowski coming to the bench. All three of them do for a shift change. And so the Devils are uncontested to bring this ahead. To Linder with a pass. It's ladled back down by Adam Mayer. Gunnarsson to play it there in the final 2.5 minutes of the second period. second effort and sent flying with a hit that time was Nazem Kadri. Meanwhile, it is turned back out for the carry-on by Gionta. Steven Gionta holding now. Threw one in front, deflected just wide by Mayer. Pelle turns with this one.
That was a nice play. Smart play by Gionta, too.
Well, Chenkov laid it back. Shen got a piece of that. It went off of Pelle behind. Taken on by Mayer again. Fourth liner's doing some work out here. Moving back in on this is Magnin. Crunches there with Kessel. Leafs fans getting a little restless here. Shen goes after this one. They're hemmed up in their own end because of the checking of this game. Tedenby is out there to join them now. He fed it further, and Shen took over there. Shen leading it on across to Gunnarsson. Handed back off the stick of Bozek. Devils are able to flick it back. Gunnarsson trying yet again. Knifed out of the air by Eliott. Fresh from the bench. Moving back ahead is Eliott. Surrounded. He got a over for a centering pass for Tedenby, and a shot blocked by Gunnarsson. Scramble there. Loose puck fed onto the back. Green able to hold. And a shot. That would kick the way to the corner by Gunnarsson. And we get a stoppage of play and a penalty coming up to the Maple Leafs.
And the Devils are going to have a minute and 14 seconds to try and tie this hockey game. But obviously, since they scored that goal, in particular, the last couple shift stops have been the best of the night for the Devils. It created some good scoring chances. And now has also created a power play. And I'm looking in front here. Oh, that's Tenenby with the rebound. Gustafsson goes down with those big legs, makes a good save. And there's a block by one of the Leafs defensemen. And so the Devils now hoping to get something going on their power play, Doc. Something that'll at least make them feel good. Shen for a cross check. His dad's here from Saskatoon tonight with some of his buddies, longtime buddies, who are also friends of Dave Brown. As you know, Brownie was from Saskatoon, and they all asked how Brownie was doing today.
Brought ahead now by Zubras. A foot of snow in Saskatoon. Lloyd Lindsay Emmerich here. Chip back on, and Kovalchuk trying to filter it through Canott, and it's sped back down the ice by Tim Brandt.
And snow will work against the Devils right now as the ice is very cut up and full of shavings, but the Devils are going to have to try and get something going before this period's over.
Zajac tangles there. It's grubbed back off by Beauchemin, and again, it will go back as the Devils make a change in their power play unit. Patrick Eliash moves out along with Tedenby. David Clarkson is out there, and undoubtedly Jason Arnott will be a part of this at some point or other. Carried back in, and that one tipped across. Tedenby a shot, and it flew wide of the short side. Eliash turning with it there, got it back on for David Clarkson. Clarkson fed it to Kovalchuk. Given on across now to Green. Dealt on further for the control there by Tedenby, and the shot ricocheted wide, and the horn sounds to end the second period. Tedenby having some words with Versteeg, and a crowd gathers.
Now Tedenby took a pretty good cross check to the arm, and he restrained himself and he looked around for some help. I will restrain myself as long as you call the penalty, but I don't think he's going to get it. But Versteeg really reefed him one.
So two periods have been played here, and the Devils will have 46 seconds of carryover time when the third period begins.
Yeah, good finish for that second period, though, for the Devils. Something they can get excited about now. That momentum we were talking about has finally swung, and the Devils deserted it through some hard work.
Do you want to read this, or should I?
Okay. You go ahead, Doc.
Experience the passion, fun, and excitement of Devils hockey with a Pepsi Family Pack. Each package includes four tickets, four Pepsis, and four hot dogs, starting at only $159. The Pepsi Family Pack is the best way to join the Devil's Army for an action-packed and affordable night out with your whole family. Get your four tickets, four Pepsis, and four hot dogs for only $159 by visiting NewJerseyDevils.com today. Christine Simpson, Phil Kessel.
Thanks very much, Doc. After no goals in the first period, the tempo really seemed to change in the second. What was different?
I don't know. I thought there was some chance in the first. We were fortunate to get two past them. Just got to keep going.
You hit a post in the first. You made no mistake in the second. I've got to ask you on that goal, were you surprised at how much time you had by the net?
Well, I kind of got lost, and Nas made a great pass, and fortunately I got the sneak 5-hole.
The Devils certainly seemed to gain momentum, though, as that period went on. How do you shut the door in the third?
We're going to have to get back to our game. We were playing well for a while and, doing little things. We'll get back to it and hopefully get a win.
Phil Kessel, thanks for your time.
No, thank you.
Phil Kessel of the Toronto Maple Leafs with a 2-1 lead after the second period of play. We'll be back with the Jaguar intermission report coming up right after this.
Pretty city, isn't it? Devils Hockey on MSG Plus is brought to you in part by your Tri-State Cadillac dealers. Visit CadillacTriState.com to find a dealer near you. By Subway Restaurants, home of the famous $5 foot-long sub. And by 5-Hour Energy, hours of energy now, no crash later. For more information, visit 5HourEnergy.com. Mr. Resch.
Well, Johan Hedberg in the nets now. Marty Brodeur obviously tweaked something. I didn't see it. There he sits on the bench. And Doc, obviously he's not being yanked because of his play.
Oh, he's actually kept them in here, hasn't he?
Yes.
But I'm wondering, pardon me for interrupting, as you see the numbers on Hedberg, I wonder if it was that play where momentarily he lost his goal stick. Remember late in the second period? And there was a sort of a gentle collision there, but as you say, you never know with a tweak. It doesn't have to be a big one.
Well, the last time Hedberg got put in, he came away with a win. Will it happen again?
Around it comes now for Tillinder to give over to Ralston. Shaken back out to center.
Well, no report that we can give you just yet. We're working on it, folks. To try and give you a hint at least at what happened to Marty Brodeur.
Here's Kovalchuk moving ahead with it now, and a shot! Oh, a strong shot that was held by Gustafson.
Oh, you like to see that out of Ilya Kovalchuk. And here's the reason why. He uses big chunks of the ice. He comes out of his own end, he uses the left wing, he cuts to the middle, and he does it early where the defenders can't stand up on him and take away the ice that they'd like to. I got to tell you, like, even a long-range shot like he just ripped there will give goaltenders trouble, and he'll get some goals off those.
Here's Green a drive. Oh, and that hit someone in front. It was Zubras. Held to the outside. 5 seconds left on the power play. Kovalchuk a shot, getting a piece of it. Was Gustafson. Poked right back by Andy Green. Cut off there and fed on for John Mitchell, and Mitchell is able to play it back out. Full strength action now as Schustrom tries to get by Tillinder. The two of them cancel. Tillinder reflexes back and got it to Green. And Green can rag through traffic and get a little time.
I saw Johan Hedberg before the game. He had his soccer ball, Doc. He did his routine of being ready for the game. So this isn't quite as difficult as some people might think. It's not ideal. It's not something a goalie hopes for each night. But certainly he'll be ready to give it his best shot. And Gustafson had to do it the last game. It came away with a big victory for the Leafs.
At least he had the intermission to get the mental part of the game together as Kessel's shot went off the defense and is played back along by Kadri.
Hold it, Doc. Goalies always have their mental game together. We don't need the intermission.
I am sorry.
We need about 30 seconds and we're ready. Okay? Otherwise, you've had a good night.
Okay. I shouldn't even laugh at that. Okay, it's played on back now to Kaberle. Gustafson ever wary back there because goalies never know when the puck's going to come right back to them by well-meaning defensemen on their team. That's why they are the best players. Played along now by Volchenkov, or trouble came there. Meanwhile, around behind, it is taken along to the outside. Grabowski with it, fed one across the net mouth off a skate. Tipped on back for Kaberle, and then poked on now, and it can be carried further by Pelle. Pelle a shot! He tried for the long side and just missed.
Well, you know, you talk about what you would like to happen for the Devils if you're a Devils fan. Love to see that fourth line who worked so hard get a big reward with a goal. Because they are having a good night tonight. But again, it's all about production and to finish off all that splendid play. They need to bury one, and they came close there.
What you hope is they can give you a good shift that builds confidence. So when guys like Kovalchuk come out there, and that line that's out right now with Dyna Zubras and Bastyunov, that they can produce something. Bastyunov moving in, locked up with Gunnarsson. They kick at it with their skates, taken away by Kovalchuk. Led onto the back now to Colin White. White a shot and a save made by Gustafson. The ice is tilted a little bit. Tilted from the power play of the Devils, and they're getting more chances here. Bastyunov rushed behind, tied up by Gunnarsson, and it's taken on for the loft back ahead by Tim Brent to center. So it is Tillinder walking it on back. Tillinder holding, tried to finesse it through, right on goal, and grabbed and held by Gustafson.
Well, let's look back here and see if we can see what happened to Brodeur. Here Marty goes down, reaches out, he gets his arm pulled. Let's see what happens after this. What? There's no striking of his arm. Oh, but you know what, Doc? It's a good call. That's got to be it, because Brodeur didn't get the stick dragged out of his hand. He dropped it. As he stretched across to make that save, I just noticed that. He dropped the stick out of pain. It wasn't that it was booted out of his hand by the attacking Leaf player, and you could see him grimace afterwards. That's a good catch.
Here's Ralston backhanding one that went wide, and Kessel moves back out with this. Andy Green back on defense as Kessel motors on, pulls and shoots, and a good save made by Hedberg in the rebound. Wound up going off David Clarkson, charges right back for the Devils. 2-1 Toronto, early third. Clarkson's pass ricocheted back out, and so he can drop back to get it further.
Okay, like Hedberg is watching Kessel doing his magic tonight. So to make his first save off Kessel, that's got to make him feel good.
Ahead with this now is Tedenby, late one that was tipped on by Jason Arnott. It's rattled on around for him again. He settles it down in front, Tedenby, and he's stoned there by Gustafson. And Gustafson is now keeping his team in this. Played back along and tipped into John Mitchell. Mitchell able to burrow ahead, taken right away by Arnott. Nice move by Eliash, got it across the Tedenby under drive, and a headhunter that got the glass. Thrown across the net mouth, wide by Arnott, kept alive by Oliver Magnin. Sent around behind, tipped on, and Arnott had it spiked away back up the boards by Komisarek, and so the Devils must retreat. But they've been able to hold the offensive zone of the New Jersey Devils and get a lot of pressure on Gustafson in this period. Walked ahead for the pitch back in by Volchenko. Beauchemin guided it behind. Komisarek takes it there. One-time Montreal Canadiens saw it drop back out near Colin White. Crushed back by Grabowski, but played by Tillinder across to White. Right back up the wing. Bastionov might have gotten a step on Beauchemin, but has to get possession. Around behind, and Beauchemin just closed him off very effectively. But right back is Bastionov in front, battling for it there. But a good poke check attempt by Gustafson. Along the boards, a good pinch by Colin White. Meanwhile, fed on back to Zubras. Through the legs, pass over to Tillinder. Tillinder is shot, and it went off Komisarek wide. Tipped right back by Gionta. Around behind where Komisarek turns again. The Leafs are kept in their own end of the ice this period. Still the battle on. Kovalchuk trying to play at close quarters to Zubras. Dug out by Grabowski. Popped one up high that settled into the seats.
Komisarek and Zubras pushing and shoving. But the Russian-speaking line, Kovalchuk, Zubras, and Bastionov having quite a game. And Around the NHL is brought to you by Tri-State Cadillac Dealers. Visit CadillacTriState.com to find a dealer near you. Well, we got some feel-good things here and a couple that aren't. Jack Capuano's first game as coach of the Devils. Unfortunately, they lost, so the Devils in the midst, the Islanders in the midst of their losing streak. And then Brett Sutter, the son of Daryl, the GM for Calgary, was traded yesterday to Carolina. And then Alexander Ovechkin and the Caps, who we're going to see Monday night, just steamrolling through the NHL right now. And the Devils will have their hands full then. But before they get there, Doc, they've got the rest of this period, a game in St. Louis. And they're hoping to come in with some confidence by the time that Monday game rolls around. And, you know, the Leafs were in the midst of an eight-game losing streak before they won the last game. So their confidence and their feel-good situation has to be a little fragile, too. The Devils have started with some good forechecking, and they want to continue that. Just want to keep going at it. I mean, to me, Doc, and I know I've said this before, this is such a desperate game for the Devils. You can't just play well and come away with nothing. You absolutely have to say, boys, we got to just scratch and claw, do anything we can. We have to get at least a point and hopefully two out of this.
One of the powerful teams in the league, the St. Louis Blues, the next opposition on Saturday night in St. Louis. Cam Jansen in the game. Zajac a shot that is deflected wide. Ralston with a turnaround shot that's blocked right back out. Andy Green spirits it across, and Parenti is able to plop it right back in on the bounce wide of the Leafs' cage. Poked onto the back. Andy Green tried to settle it down, and it is carried away by David Clarkson. Gave it back on to Parenti. Builder through now for Eliash, and a shot blocked out. Another try, and that one blocked down as well. Strong defensive play by Luke Shen, not once but twice. Tedenby gave it on to Eliash. Feathered it through to Tedenby around behind. chased there by Caberle. Tedenby turning. What'll he do? Shot one that bounced off of Caberle, who was man-to-man defensively on him all the way. Nice work by Tedenby. Chopped it on, and Arnott is able to hang on for a moment before it's threaded back in by Bozek. Carried back on by Corenti. That one knifed back down. Corenti laid it across. Settled down there by Green with 7-10 gone in the third period. A lot of effort by both teams, but no scoring. Ahead comes Zubras. Drops it back, and a drive is blocked down. Kovalchuk again, and that one sent up high and out of play by Beauchemin. 2-1. Leafs still leading in Toronto.
Lost in all this, very special night for Matt Parenti. He's playing his first game here in Toronto. He's from Mississauga, only half an hour away. He's got 30-plus family and friends, but his father, Frank, and his mother, Josie, are here. But what's really special is his grandmother, Maria. She's getting to watch her grandson play for the first time. Doc, all three of those names I mentioned are all from the old country. Parenti, obviously, is an Italian name, but his parents, as well as grandmother, immigrated to Canada. And like all immigrants who come here, they immediately fell in love with hockey. And then their son makes it to the big show. Doesn't get any better than that.
Probably sleepless nights for everybody. Maybe not Matt, but everybody associated with the family. And a lot of it out of just the excitement of waiting for this day and then seeing it unfold right here in Toronto. Kadri laid that one back in and sprinted after it. Ball takeoff there to make sure he understands. Meanwhile, it's taken to the outside. Phil Kessel up for grabs at the half court. Piazza defending him. They try to muscle it along. Volchenkov is in the way. Working in deep is Dyna Zubras again. Zubras still there. Fires it back around. Komisarek able to keep play alive. Dealt it around behind, but it is Volchenkov with 12:08 to go in the third period. Battle continues at the half court. Led on back to Beauchemin. Laid on for Kessel, but it escaped near Volchenkov. Tries to play it along again, and the forecheck this time is working on behalf of the Leafs. Stepping to this, though, is Dyna Zubras. Ladle it on back for control by Magnin, and a shift change for Toronto. Answered up front by one for New Jersey. Gianta deflected that one down, came to the bench for a change. Zajac is out there to test with Komisarek, and so the Leafs are able to outlet. Shoved on now to Clark MacArthur, dropped it ahead. Here's Kuhlman moving on. For Grabowski was knocked right back toward Kuhlman, one-handed on by Tillinder. To the back it comes, and Ollie with a shot that's speared away by the netminder Hedberg. Colin White with good protection there, but it's taken right away and hooked on back by Kuhlman. Roughed up was MacArthur by Colin White. White stepping by again, the leading hitter in total hits on this team with 40 entering the game tonight. Colin White watches as Tillinder throws this one right back to him, and then he hands on to Clarkson. Clarkson a drive, and that one caught and held by Gustafson. We were talking about the Leafs. It has been since 1967, 42 completed seasons in that time. The Leafs have missed the playoffs 16 times, including the last five in a row. They've been to the conference final five times, not in the final. Half of those seasons have been more wins than losses in 60 minutes.
One of their best years was the lockout year. Didn't lose a game.
Oh, what a guy.
That's one of the jokes up here.
Here is Arnott turning it around. There are plenty of them, and they have plenty of creative minds in Toronto to think of those, and many of them are employed by companies that buy ink by the ton. Given across now for Shen, hands it back ahead for the carry-on by Versteeg. He's got a man breaking Schustrom. Versteeg holds and shoots. It's off Hedberg and came along to Schustrom again. Filtered it behind for Versteeg, but instead it's Andy Green, who seems to be out there every other shift tonight and has had a strong game. He lobs this one back in and goes right after it. Knifed away from him by Shen, taken by Tedenby. And inside the trapezoid, it's handled easily by Tim Brent. 26 years of age. Sees this play develop ahead, and Zubras can take that. Versteeg wanted a penalty and palms toward the referee saying, oh, go on. Ahead comes Zubras, and a shot save! Gustafson on a strong wrister by Dyna Zubras. Battled for there by Vasyunov. And the Devils are the harder working of the two teams, but will it bring a reward? Skipped on now for Zubras. Zubras laid it across, carried back out by Volchenkov. Walks it on ahead, and an 80-footer is caught and held by Gustafson, who will wait. And so will we. 9:48 to go, third period, 2-1 Toronto.
Dyna Dennis Zubrus having an excellent game. If you're going to play center with Kovalchuk, this is what I like. Now watch Zubrus here. You're going to see Kovalchuk come in the picture. But he says, I'm not giving it to him now. He's going to be under pressure. Look, see, trailing the play. And what the opposition's doing, they know where Kovalchuk is. You see how they're backing up? So Dennis Zubrus says, I'm taking it to the net. And Doc, tonight he's been able to handle the puck. And he's had some room because the defender's so intent and aware of where Kovalchuk is that it will give Zubra some open ice. And Kovalchuk's fine with that because there will be rebounds, there will be times when he'll get open. And, you know, the Russian-speaking line here, of course, Lithuanian and the other two Russian, have really come together tonight. I really like the potential of Vashinov, Kovalchuk, and Zubras if they can continue what they've started here tonight.
Well, it's a lot of hard work by Zubras, especially down low defensively, where a lot of things shift the other way, and we saw an example of that the last time this group was out there. But now they're back in that same end of the ice again, must have their misfortune. It's taken back along now and controlled by Vashinov. Flew one ahead, and it is floated on. Rod Pelly came up with that right in front. Kovalchuk tries to control, and it's swept away with authority to the corner. Good job by Beauchemin there. Meanwhile, taken along by Rod Pelly, and it trickled around for Komisarek. Closed off by Kovalchuk. Puck taken and thrown by Magnin, and another try, and another try. Kovalchuk battles with Beauchemin, and the Leafs are able to start back with it. 9:05 to go, third period, and the probing continues at either end of the ice in this low-scoring game. More jabbing away at the puck. Brown comes by for this.
Rare shift for the fourth line. Colton Orr out there.
Mike Brown after this one. Orr is coming along toward the bench. Looked like for a shift change, but he's staying out there. Meanwhile, it's Zajac after it. Punched along and off of David Clarkson. Started ahead by Orr. Regathered by Colin White of the Devils' defense and shoved off a stick right back out again. Go Leafs go is the chant that you're hearing a little of. Talinder drops. Ralston a shot and a good answer there by Gustafson on a strong shot by Brian Ralston.
Gustafson playing really deep in the crease. I like the Devils' thought process.
Mitchell up with this one. Mitchell with a shot that's knocked down by Talinder. It's hooked around behind.
They're shooting from long range, Doc, and it's a good idea because I'm watching Gustafson. I don't know if it's his plan, but he's halfway from the top of the crease to the goal line. So there's some room from far out if you could just hit it. At least you could maybe get a rebound.
Good point. This is taken by Hedberg. Turned into traffic, though. Hrabowski sent flying by Corenti. There'll be a penalty coming up from this.
Well, let's have a good look at it. I don't know. The puck's loose. Fierce battle here. Grabowski, did he just go down or did he really get drilled to the ice? Tough play from Mascheretti. He's trying to be aggressive. He's trying to help out his goalie here. Hedberg can't find him. Let's watch. Here you see. Oh, you know what? He did go down, but here's where Matt's got to say, I got to go after the puck. Because if you touch a guy there and he goes sprawling like Grabowski, you're going right where Parenti sits in the sin bin.
Leafs power play is 1-for-2, three shots, including a power play goal, the first goal of the game by Grabowski. Hedberg, a little trouble there for Andy Green, worked to the outside, one back, Verstiga shot, knocked around in front and can be played back out again by Zajac, shorthanded with Eliash, led it ahead. Eliash moving, but the ranks are closed quickly as Beauchemin came from the bench. Right back ahead with this, marching on, and in a lot of traffic as MacArthur and the stray stick threw him offside.
Well, Patrick Eliash didn't see that blindside because they were in the middle of a change. He thought he had some room to dangle, and he's not too happy. But how about this? 26 career points for Patrick Eliash versus Toronto. The only Devil in history who's had more points is the guy standing behind him, Johnny McClain. So who knows? Could Eliash tie him tonight? Could he pull within one? The Devils are going to need him or somebody to come up a hero here tonight in Toronto and score that second goal.
Work back ahead for Bozak. Oh, was he ever smashed by Colin White. And White comes up with a puck, tried to clear, could not. Bozak flipped one, and it's knifed away from the reach of Kadri. Up the boards tip, Kaverley across. Versteeg sends it further. Held there and controlled now by Kuhlman. Kuhlman swung it back to Kaverley again. Walks it on across, deals it back to Kuhlman. Got a good shot, one-timer by Versteeg, he scores!
else we were watching was just window dressing for this one play. And it's the right-handed shooting for Stieg, who was deadly against Nashville the last time the Leafs played. He scored two power play goals here. And here you see him setting up on the left wing. And that pass is a dandy. There, Gaberle goes back across to the other side. Pass through the seam. And Hintberg comes hard. But this high shot, just right over the short side shoulder into the top part of the net. And Christopher Stieg continues his hot goal scoring with a big goal for the Leafs.
Point of game string for him has gone to four games now. He's got three goals in that span. Fifth of the year, fourth on the power play for the former Chicago Blackhawk. And he comes to the bench. No, it looked like he was coming to the bench and he decided, no, I'm going to stay out. But it is a 3-1 lead, so 6:20 to go, and now it becomes that big scoreboard clock, an enemy of the Devils. They've got to charge back and get one so that they can at least pull the goaltender late and force a second. Or score on successive shots in 5 seconds, who knows?
Yeah, maybe draw a penalty. That would be their most helpful situation, at least to start.
Arnett flips, fed one in front, a backhander. What a great toe save by Gustafson on Patrick Elion.
He's been good on the low shots of the corner, hasn't he?
Especially in the third period, he's been key for his team when they were reeling a bit. Caverly played that one to the corner. Talinder back to that, chipped it on near Elias, jostled off by Kuhlman, and played on back to center where it's Shen and Caverly defensively. Traditionally, these two teams, when they play here in Toronto, have low-scoring games. That's been the same tonight, 3-1. That is not the same in Philadelphia, where Ron Jaworski has sneaked for 2 yards. Vinny Testaverde has completed a pass to Shannon Sharp. And it is 7-7 Tampa Bay Philadelphia. A save has been made by Hedberg. So Sam Weiss and Buddy Ryan don't know how to react. It's a tie game. Here it's 3-1 Toronto.
IOTV presents the HD highlight of the game. IOTV brings you the best HD experience free. And here's that goal by Phil Kessel. Really an easy one in terms of him having time and a lot of space to look through the five hole, and he whips it through Marty Brodeur's legs. Right now, that is the GWG goal so far. Leafs have added another one just moments ago, so the Devils down two. Have to put on a big rush here to try and get back in this.
Meanwhile, we don't want you to think we're neglecting information on Marty Brodeur. We have none, and we have people here who can get it if it's provided, and we know you're concerned about that. But here is Andy Green giving it across now to Colin White. White with a pass up the wing. Travis Zajac had it bounce away. Shipped back out again by Caverle. Striding after it is Andy Green.
Marty Brodeur is sitting on the bench, which tells me he tweaked that elbow. And if an emergency, he had it going, he still could. But Marty's so good about saying, you know what, if I'm not 100%, why should I go back in there? But if he was in the dressing room, I would show a lot more concern than what I'm seeing here now.
The rules permit to use any available goaltender should Marty not have been down at the bench area. And any available goaltender would mean that a headset would probably plop onto the table here and I would be alone.
It'd be between Johnny Bauer and I, huh? And that would be a toss-up.
He's loyal to the Leafs, you're loyal to the Devs, so I think it would be by default.
Okay, in the old days though, right, you could use the other team's backup if your goalie went down, which would be kind of a compromising position for him. But the integrity of the goaltenders always at the top level. Well, here's a third goal. Now let's see, now the Versteeg, he's just been waiting here. All this other stuff going on. And here's that, oh, what a pass. Who was that? Was that Caverle? There, that is a great look by our down low camera. It had to come off the ice, and it was right where Versteeg could just pound that thing. And that was a brilliant pass. Was it Caverle, the primary?
Yeah.
Okay, well, we talked about him being on the trading block, maybe down the road, and there's an indication of what you're going to maybe get from him. A timeout has been called by New Jersey, no, by Toronto. Well, that's interesting.
Probably from the icing that they're going to just give guys a breather here since they are stuck for coming back out. At least the offensive zone faceoff favors the Devils here. But at any rate, Tampa Bay is now ahead of Philadelphia 8-7 in that one, and that ties the league record since the lockout for most goals by two teams in a game at 15.
We don't know for sure. The two goalies started and were in there for like the first 10, but you wonder, are they still in there? I was in there for 13, Ronnie Lowe and I, but we split it. So if both goalies finish that one, that tells you a new trend going on in the league. That, you know, you make a mess and you, not that the goalies do their fault, but you start, you finish. I like that.
Here's a feed in front. Oh, and having a chance at it was Arnott on a nice centering pass from Patrick Elias, but again, Gustafson comes up with it, 26 years of age, 6'3", 193 pounds from Sweden.
Yeah, he's got all kinds of potential. He's obviously waiting in the wings because Jaguar, the starting goalie, is going to play a lot for at least another year or so. So he may not get the bulk of the work yet, but when he does, he certainly looks like he's going to rise to the occasion.
Elias popped one in front off of Grabowski's stick. Another turnaround try by Tedenby was blocked. Tedenby returns quickly to Patrick Elias. Shoveled on back. Kalinder gave it across. Andy Green has to rescue it off the boards. And a chip behind where it can eventually be played by the Leafs and shaken on by MacArthur. Off of Kuhlman. Brushed it on and Grabowski got it. Denied once by Green, and then it is Kuhlman turning, shoved by Green, threw it on goal, and Hedberg blocked it. MacArthur took it, shoved off by Kalinder, his ex-teammate in Buffalo. Clark MacArthur tries to play further, and Jason Arnott controlled for a moment, but then it's up for grabs and sped right back again. Grabowski took that one from Kuhlman. Fed it for Kuhlman, but behind it's Andy Green with under 3 minutes to go in regulation, and the double deficit is two. Tedenby could not turn and take. Caberle wipes out. There to help out is Luke Shen. Shen, just 21 years of age from Saskatoon. Carried back ahead now. Worked back on by Kadri. Kessel wiped up there by Colin White. Floated on to Kovalchuk. Moves ahead to Vasyunov, but instead he gives it across as Vasyunov was breaking ahead, but it is Volchenkov working it back in. Charging to the bench, Hedberg. Extra attacker is out for New Jersey, but the net is empty as Kessel marches on and is hit by a couple. Puck up for grabs and dug out by Zubras. Fed on back to Colin White, but into traffic, settled down, and Shustrom hit the post with a shot. Angled on back. Devils caught a break there as marching back up with it is Zubras with 2 minutes and 2 seconds to go in regulation.
Imagine if the Devils were to come back now. After that, open net miss.
Andy Green sort of dangling it there for Shustrom, wasn't he? Moved right back by Kalinder up the wing. Elias a drive, and it went wide to the short side. Played back on by Kalinder. Moshaman gave it up to Kalinder again. Came back up for Kovalchuk. Sent it around behind, and Zajac moves for it there with Komisarek. Komisarek only got it as far as Elias. The battle on. Kept alive by Green again and held. Six attackers for the Devils. Thrown in front. Oh, directed on goal and a save made by Gustafson. Scrambled in front, and he got a piece of another one. Kovalchuk working it off the boards. Jabbed it on back to Kalinder again. Kalinder fed it across. Andy Green with it there. Screen set. Drive went wide as Clarkson was standing in front of the netminder. Just getting back to his feet is Zajac. It is pumped around off the back of the cage. Battled for there. Kovalchuk hooked one in front. Cut off and angled back out again by Shustrom. Gathered in by Andy Green in the final minute of play. Elias able to circle. Marches back in with it again. And the Devils pour in. Elias a drive. Getting a piece of it was Gustafson. Looks like the first star of the night. Flipped on back now and ladled down by Andy Green with 43 to go. On to Kovalchuk trying to get by MacArthur. Here's Arnott to drive, and that one was steered wide. Played on by Zubras, dealt behind to Jason Arnott, 35 to go. The Devils are behind by two. Chopped back out in front, taken on there, and angled across by Volchenkov. Kept alive by Ralston. Drives one that is right on the money for Arnott. Tried to float it in front. Caberle said no. Came back out again. The Leafs play to center. Hooked across by Vasyunov with 15 to go. Zubras finessed it on. Kovalchuk got it there. Played it too far for Arnott to the last eight. Chip back down. Going back for it is Volchenkov. No icing. Volchenkov outreaches Kuhlman, and the Leafs have won it 3-1.
Devils 12th shot here in the third period, but that man there, especially down low, really was a brick wall. He just put those pads post to post. And the Devils not having any room really to try and get loose and get the puck upstairs. We're just firing and whacking at it around the crease, and he got them all there in the third. The Devils again, only one goal tonight, zero the last game. And Johnny McClain really can't say a whole lot more, Doc, than he said before this game when he said, we've just got to score. And I'll leave it up to the fans, really, to try and figure out why that isn't happening. Because it wasn't from lack of effort. It wasn't from some good work along the boards and cycling and putting the puck in scoring positions. They just can't finish, and that's been their biggest problem.
The guys who finished the night with smiles on their faces are those guys, the Leafs, and Jonas Gustafsson, who was terrific in goal tonight. Coming up, the Devils postgame, you'll hear from Coach John McClain, get highlights and analysis of the Devils and Leafs. The Devils postgame show immediately following this game. And the task gets pretty large as the Devils head into St. Louis to play a team that is tied for sixth in the West, only 4 points out of the Western Conference lead. Final score in this contest tonight in Toronto. The Leafs 3, the Devils 1. More in a moment.